of the Lord, accept the Holy Spirit. And you are seeking the Holy Spirit, you are actually seeking the mind of the Lord. And the Bible say one thing that is very, very, very explosive is that, but you have the mind of Jesus.
Mind of Jesus.
That is very fantastic. I mean, people always say God's way is higher than our way, and then God's thoughts is higher than our thought. And then the author of the Bible say this, but we have the mind of the Holy Spirit, the mind of Jesus, through the Holy Spirit. And therefore, we are seeking, where we are seeking to walk with Holy Spirit, you are actually seeking to understand the mind of Christ. And it's going to be very fantastic, because then you're going to pray along God's perfect will. And that's the right direction that we're doing. It's just like yesterday we expand. El Shaddai is expanding its border to Indonesia in a powerful way. And I just hinted to you, we're going to expand our border beyond to many nations. God is opening up the doors, and we're going to see more. And it is even much more important than we must know the mind of Christ, right? We need to get connected to the Holy Spirit so that the mind of Christ is connected to us, and we move in constant connection to the Lord Jesus, so that we will be at all time thinking, moving, and then acting in His perfect will. Amen. All right.
Amen.
Let's just pray. Just a short prayer. Then I'm not allowed long prayer at this time, because otherwise
you can.
No, why? Why pray long prayer?
Until
12 o'clock, and then only I alone left. The rest all left this place already.
No, tonight we stay with you.
Not the time yet. Okay, going to be, but not the time yet. All right, our Father, we are so thankful. We just want to thank you, Father God, when in Old Testament and in all generations we say that who knows the mind of God? Who knows what is in the Lord's heart? Meaning to tell us that we are just far, because you say the way of the Lord is far above us. The mind of Christ is the mind of the Lord is so high above us, meaning we have no way to get near, no way to get close, as if we will never in all our life able to understand fully the mind of Christ. But yet, Father God, we are so thankful through what Jesus has done. You will declare we have the mind of Christ. So beautiful. Lord, it is no more beyond reach. It is now through the Holy Spirit. It is now through the blood of Jesus we have the mind of Christ. It is for us, Father God, to offer ourselves living sacrifice unto you, so that we be cleansed and purified. So that the thought of the Father has become our thoughts. So that the way of the Father has become our way. And the way that the ideas of the Lord, what is going through in smile, will become our mind, because we are connected with this very special hotline, the Holy Spirit. And Lord, we thank you that you have made Holy Spirit approachable, because you sent it to us from the throne of God. And we thank you, the Holy Spirit, for just coming right inside us to become that link and connection between us and the Father and the Lord Jesus, so that we then receive the mind of Christ. Our Father is just unbelievable. It is just inconceivable, but it is true, because your word has so declared. We therefore receive, we rejoice, receive with excitement, Father God, that as we seek to walk with the Holy Spirit, we will be thinking the mind of the Lord. We will be doing the way of the Lord. We'll be understanding your way. Father God, we thank you that you make it possible for us. While we are hungry and thirsty and looking to you, God. Hungry, Father God, that as you say, we must be like your Father. Lord, we just thank God for that statement. It is not just a blessing, a wish from the Lord Jesus say, you must be like your Father. Lord, today we thank God. Through the cleansing blood of Jesus, we are like our Father. And we're going to move into that realm, Father God, dwelling in that realm, and a continuous fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And through Holy Spirit, we have fellowship with the Father at all time and in all places and in all things. And He fills our mind. He infuses our every cells. Now, once again, we choose, Father God, to surrender ourselves in trust and obedience unto You all the days of our life. Lord, it is so blessed and so exciting to just know, to just thank God for that impossibility that has become possible for us. Amen. We just ask, Father God, that You draw the hunger out of every one of us. Amen. That our mind and thought will be like what David, he say, I hunger, I thirst, and I long for the Father, for the Lord. Our Father, He was just longing for it. But this day, through the blood of Jesus, through the Father, Holy Spirit that is in us, we are now connected with a highway to our Father. In all coming to the Father, in all thinking about the thoughts of the Father, and the mind of Christ that is in us. Father God, we thank You. Who are we, but yet we thank You, Father God. We will not let go any of this opportunity, things You have declared in Your word. So now we receive it. And Lord, we can walk in the days ahead as He is, as the Lord Jesus is. So are we on this earth. We walk like Jesus the day He walked on earth. As the Father is, so was Jesus when He walked on the Sea of Galilee. But this day, Father God, since Christ has gone to be with the Father and has brought there His blood and offer of Himself, His blood at the altar of God, we are now, the way to the holies of holies are now open for us. And the veil has been torn apart. Now we are so thankful. All this speaks so much of Your love for us, because it takes Your life, it takes every drop of Your blood, and even take Your body to be torn apart just for us. This will be torn, Cain. Now we thank You. And we thank You for the enduring pains, and this, that You despise the shame, because You see this kind of possibility, this kind of blessing, this kind of joy that come to all of us. You and Jesus, Father, the Son, and we, His bride, has come together in the perfect unity. Lord, we thank You, Father God. Just take our hand, hold our hands, and lead us into that tremendous joy and peace, tremendous time with You, God, the kind of unity, Father God, the kind of oneness with You. Lord, we long for it, we want it, and we offer ourselves whatever it takes, oh Father. Just take us, Father God, into that level of intimacy with You all the days of our life. Lord, we thank You for all these who are hungry and thirsty for You. That according to your promise, the hungry one shall be filled, and the thirsty shall be quenched. That we all will be satisfied, because these are holy longing for You, and You will not despise. In fact, you long to see this become a reality as day-to-day, moment-to-moment relationship with You that is satisfying not only unto us, but also unto You. Our Father, we thank You this night. We thank You, and we are proud. We are just declare again and again, we are blessed to be your sons and daughters. We are blessed to be your king and priest. We are blessed to be the body of Christ. We are blessed to be the bride of Christ, pure and holy unto you. And we thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen.